In a sense, in Handel's Messiah, only the weight of the scriptures beats the beauty of the music. But beyond the sweetness of the melodies and the beauty of the harmony, may we come under the full weight of the Holy Scriptures. The entire work is in three parts, and we have covered the first part, which dealt with the person and work of Jesus and the angelic announcement of his birth to the shepherds. We are now turning to part two, which addresses what we call the passion of Jesus, Jesus' suffering and death. His resurrection and ascension are also addressed. We will also see how human rulers reject the good news of Christ and how God, in his sovereignty, crushes them through Christ. The Bible contains some strong language about our state as sinners. Here is one of them. We all, without exception, from Osama to Obama, like sheep have gone astray. We are lost. We have turned every one of us to his own way, neither knowing nor seeking God. But someone who loves us came to bring us back to God. He bore our griefs and carried our sorrows. He was rejected, dejected, despised, derided, beaten, stricken, spat on, looked down upon, all for our sins. He is Jesus, the Messiah. If you believe in him, you will not perish, but have everlasting life. If you have not done so already, I urge you, by the mercies of God, to invite him into your heart as we take the next set of pieces. Ladies and gentlemen, behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world.
Sorrows and acquainted Where the stars standing light in him. He shall be standing light in him. Let him deliver him in me. Let him deliver him in me. If he delight in him, he shall be standing light in him. Let him deliver him in me. Let him deliver him in me. If he delight in him, he shall be standing light in me.
Have pity on him.
beyond the sweetness of the melody and the beauty of the harmony, may we come under the full weight of the Holy Scriptures. Jesus is unique in many ways. Here are three of them. One, he is the Son of God. Two, he is superior to angels and they worship him. Three, as a warrior, he defeated death, the ultimate captivity to which all men are subject. This is how the Bible puts it in one of the scriptures. He led captivity captive. He is the King of kings. He is the Lord mighty in battle. These 3 points mean that Jesus is divine. All that God the Father is, Jesus is. And God enjoins us all, the company of preachers, to preach this one word given to us, the gospel of peace. The good news that Jesus is the Savior of the world. And oh, how God loves it when we do so. He says, how beautiful are the feet of them that preach the gospel of peace. Ladies and gentlemen, Jesus, the Messiah, the King of glory, is coming. Nanebo, oh, Nanebo, Henio, Miapefiagbona. So lift up your gates. Oh, lift up your heads, O ye gates, ye everlasting doors. The King of glory shall come in. Open your heart and let him come in as king over your life.
Oh, let's take counsel together. Take counsel, take counsel together against the Lord and against this unknown. Against the Lord, against the Lord.
Of the melody and the harmony and its beauty, may we come under the full weight of the Holy Scriptures. Sinful man prefers himself to God. Self-rule to the rule of God's word, and self-worship to the worship of the one true God. So in stark opposition to God's word, the nations rage and imagine vain things. but God laughs at them, for he knows the bounds of their powers. He is giving them time. True power lies with God. Follow the way of God in all your choices. Soon and very soon, the Lord God Omnipotent will reign over all these kingdoms. Jesus will clear all the kings and laws of our time and establish his rulership on earth as King of Kings and Lord of Lords. What we just heard is the Hallelujah Chorus. Some have called it the Christian's Anthem. It is direct from Scripture, from Revelation chapter 11 and verse 15. Thank you. where will you spend eternity? Seriously, where will you spend eternity? Seriously, where will you spend eternity? Here is the Christian's hope. As Christ died and rose again, so those of us who die in Christ shall rise too. For as in Adam all die, even so in Christ shall all be made alive. Let us live in hope of the resurrection, that at the end of time the trumpet shall sound, and the dead in Christ shall be raised with new bodies, never to die again. And that is why the Christian can ask, O grave, where is thy victory? O death, where is thy sting? Beyond the sweetness of the melody and the beauty of the harmony, may all of us come under the full weight of the Holy Scriptures.
Shall be changed. trumpet shall sound.
Thank you. Lord.